Hi, I'm Delroy Lindo, and this is The Breakdown. Spike called me, told me about the film, and said he wanted to send me the script. I read the script. My initial reaction to the Trumpian aspect of my character, Paul, was trepidation. I didn't want to do it. I called Spike and I let him know that I was having a problem coming to terms with that aspect of the character. And Spike thought about it for a few days, but then he texted me and he said he really needed Paul to be a Trumpite. I asked Spike to give me some more time with the script. He said, no problem. And I was able to rationalize in my head and empathize, importantly, with Paul's decision to cast that vote as he did in 2016.
I see ghosts, y'all. I see ghosts.
It was written in the script that Paul has a short fuse. So then my job became deconstructing what those descriptions meant. So Paul says in one of the scenes, when you've been fucked over as much as I have in life, you learn the signs of all those rat bastards out there. I took that literally as I was reading the script, meaning Paul is speaking about betrayals that he has suffered. And that comports with the experience of Vietnam vets that I spoke with. The slights, the betrayals, the loss, that's the genesis of Paul's emotional state.
We bloods, we got a bond. We fought in an immoral war that wasn't ours.
My perception, my quote unquote understanding of the average Trump supporter is Caucasian. I mean, a very small percentage of Black people voted for this individual, but there's a very, very marked difference in terms of Paul having cast that vote, because I think for a lot of his base, there is the component of maintaining white supremacy. Clearly, that is not a component of why Paul cast that vote.
Come on now, Dad.
What do you want, David?
And Equal Share for helping you find it.
Helter.
I didn't know Jonathan prior to coming to this film. We had dinner with Spike and Isaiah. Very soon thereafter, Jonathan called me and said, words to the effect, look, if there's anything that we should be talking about in terms of our relationship, I'd love to do that. The fact that he reached out to me as he did let me know this is a certain kind of actor. This is an actor whose stance vis-a-vis the work is similar to my own. There's very little makeup, next to no makeup, and absolutely no computer generated anything. So it was really about the truth of the scene, playing the truth of the scene. Because it said in the script, during these flashback scenes, the Bloods will be the age they are now. That was specifically written. When we filmed those scenes, it also made sense. I was just thrilled as an actor, as a human being, as a Black man, to get to inhabit with my compadres, those scenes. Because those scenes showed us being very valiant, defending our cause, fighting for the country, frankly, fighting for each other, fighting and protecting each other. Rarely do audiences get to see us being valiant and courageous and loving and protective of each other in that way, which is what that was. Spike exhibited the creative and professional regard for me that he has always exhibited anytime we have worked together. And as a result of that, he gives me elbow room. He gives me the space to investigate. If I'm inspired to say or do something in the moment, I always have the space with Spike to do it, as long as it is in service of the text. The story.
Memphis, Tennessee. A white man assassinate Dr. Martin Luther King.
The Bloods are presented, I'd like to believe, I want to believe, I know that they are presented as human beings. All of our foibles, all of our faults, all of our various personality traits, characteristics. In the final analysis, we are, as I said, valiant, courageous, loving human beings. if audiences, anybody watching this, walks away from this film with an enhanced appreciation for understanding of not just Black male humanity, but by extension, Black humanity, I think it will be a positive thing, because where we are in the country right now is happening as a result of the rejection, the 400 year rejection of African descended people and our humanity, which means it's okay to shoot us down like animals in the street. Even if we're unarmed, it's okay to do that, because we're not human after all. What I hope is that there is this enhanced appreciation for who we are as human beings. Obviously, I want it, we all want for this not to be a moment, and we want it to be the beginning of some substantive, we want it to be the beginning of a paradigm shift in terms of the acknowledgement of our humanity and our rights, the same rights that we have as people of color, as any other human being on the planet.